Johnny Hawthorne here with Andy Timmons, NAMM 2020 at the Exotic booth. And Andy, how's the show? First, thanks for coming.
Oh, great. Great to be here. No, it's going awesome. I was telling somebody earlier that I've been coming to almost every NAMM since 1986.
Wow.
So, yeah, I'm an old guy. And it's one of those things where it's mainly for me. I mean, obviously there's lots of gear, but it's seeing all the players and all the people that you meet all over the world in all types of different venues and music distributors and shops, then all your friends and all the music companies that you work with. Everybody's in one place at the same time. And then over the years, I've got three fans.
Yeah.
So I run into my three fans. No, but it's an incredible situation. But as we are both evident, we're losing our voice.
Yes.
Because you're trying to talk over this cacophony. But it's an energy, and it's something I look forward to every year. You know?
Excellent. Yeah. And you've been a BB pre-user for many years. You had
one of the earliest ones. I mean, I remember hooking up and just immediately identifying with the pedal. It was like magic for me, you know?
Yes.
And it just worked from the get-go as far as if I wanted to boost into my clean, it worked great. If I wanted to hit the front end of my distortion channel with a little bit extra, it was just perfect. And I use the same setting for each.
Excellent.
But I do have two BBs on my board right now.
You do?
And an RC.
All right.
I have three exotics on right now. So I can have a couple different settings for a couple different BB things. And I'm going a little more extreme with treble occasionally.
Okay. All right.
But you have to come to the gig to find out what that's all about. Yeah.
And maybe in the future, maybe we'll do an RC Andy Timmons?
I have some ideas.
All
funny
right.
enough. But that's been a great sound because a lot of my favorite things to play is a very delicate, clean kind of thing. And the RC is a good tool to help me achieve that color. It's got a nice top end to it. So yeah, I would like to refine a couple things, but it's a beautiful pedal as it exists as well, obviously.
Okay, so we'll look forward to that, maybe doing something in the future. And finally, when you think of exotic tone, what does exotic mean to you?
There's so many pedal companies, it's overwhelming. I just immediately identified with the quality of the tone I was getting, the clarity. And I love the people in the company too.
Okay.
I mean, that's kind of a big deal for me. If I'm going to collaborate with somebody, it's got to be a great product to start with, but there's got to be people that I resonate with. I mean, that's really as important as the gear almost, you know, because if you're going to really work together and try to have integrity together, that's important. So I resonate with the gear, but also the people. And so it's been a great relationship. So I look forward to the future. And I feel honored to have a company I can go to with ideas and to work with and have the confidence to know it's going to be great.
Excellent. All right. Well, thank you for stopping by.
Thanks, Johnny. Thank you so much, man.
Have a great show. We'll talk to you
guys
later.
Thank you.